Three players, the completionist, the Grumpcade.
I'm having a great time.
Shut up. Next time on Hello.
Hi.
That's like the most spastic fucking opening.
Yeah.
Okay. What is that? The Death Star in the background?
Yeah, the Death Egg. Which, from this Sonic, I think becomes a reoccurring bit.
Yeah.
Why are you rocking
back? I don't know. I just thought it was
like a secret. You can fall down there.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
I guess. I think you can come up from there.
The music is fucking perfect for that. Doing a little dance like, go,
Sonic!
It always reminded me of Bill Nye the Science Guy. Every time.
Bill. Oh my god, you got hit by that guy?
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Well, that's a different guy.
How did you not know that, completionist?
So adorable. It's fucking in his little cubby.
Futuristic teacups like, right there.
I'm warm. Nice, go up the screw. Go up that screw. Screw that screw.
Go! Alright.
Oh my god, it's like the one sample they have in this fucking game. Alright, I wanna see how good you can do on this bonus stage.
I'm gonna try- okay, I'm not-
Alright, mister.
I'm not amazing, but I'm gonna try my best to keep
it going. I can do it for an entire episode.
Yeah, you were like 10 minutes, and it's like, oh shit, 10 minutes.
10 minutes, that's a whole extra episode.
Looks like you're not doing so great right now.
Yeah, looks like 10 minutes isn't really gonna happen, hey.
Probably not.
Hey.
Choking real hard right now.
Outside, very good. Oh, yeah. Oh, fuck.
1998.
Thought I had a pussy. Sorry, what are we talking about?
I was talking about Resident Evil 4.
Oh, Resident Evil. Oh, that's a great one.
Hey,
I've never played Resident Evil in my life.
You remember that opening?
Yeah.
Oh, except the first one.
Raccoon City.
I just remember.
It's my favorite.
No. Aw, damn it.
Oh, you got prickly feelings.
Oh, you lost all your rings.
Oh, 35 of them.
Reminds me of the time that someone said something mean to me and I got a prickly feeling all across my body.
I just get it in my heart.
Really?
And then I like... And then I wanna take a shower, like a really long one.
We used to- graduating camp in high school, we had like this, we had this exercise, because I went to a weird Catholic school, and
where
they were just like-
into like a shower with all the boys
yeah,
together.
No, it was
there's an old man.
But they had this thing set up on the wall in
damn
the camp.
Damn it!
Ugh.
They had this thing set up on the wall- you're not very good at this.
You're doing great, Jerome.
Set up on the wall in the camp.
I'm still here.
And you
guys said nothing about
getting rings.
Yeah. It was about longevity at this point.
Oh, well, longevity,
like,
you're doing great.
Fucking like Windows screensaver background is really, really-
It's so fucking 80s, 90s. But anyway, so they set up this- camp wall with everyone's name in these little envelopes that are stuck to the wall. So you could walk over and you were supposed to give someone like a, what's called a warm fuzzy, and it was supposed to be a note that was written saying like,
oh, sure.
Oh, you fucked up. That said like, oh, fuzzies. Like, Russ, I think you're really great because such and such, or,
that was a
waste
Catherine, of
time. You're great because this and that.
Yeah.
So I like opened mine up and I had none, and I was like, oh, and everyone else was like reading through their warm fuzzies and getting like nice feelings. And I looked in deeper, and I realized I had one, and I was like, oh, great, I got a warm fuzzy! And I pulled it out, and it was from my friend Justin, who was a fucking asshole, and he just goes, hi, Ross, this is a call prickly, have a shit-fucking day. And I always remembered that. Aww. It actually did hurt at the time, but then I realized
I'm
later.
I'm sure it did!
It was pretty funny.
That shit's, like, so legit back then.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Oh, my God.
Oh god, why did I choose to go on this adventure? It's been nothing but spinning and running and hitting walls.
Oh,
why
no.
Am I Sonic the Hedgehog? Why have I been forever cursed?
I wish when he busted open one of the robots, like just a wet naked guy came out. He's like, oh!
Finally! Thank you!
I was a bumblebee for 3 days!
Also, why are they building the Death Egg on a planet? It seems really
stupid. Oh my god, really?
Wow, you're really bad at this.
Maybe he's really good at being bad, Ross.
Yeah, maybe that's what he's aiming for.
Whenever I stream playing games, people are always like, oh, I thought you were good at games! And I'm like, hey, I never said I was the best gamer on the planet, I'm just really fucking patient.
I just said I could get shit done. Don't see you getting anything done. Where's your career? Get something done.
Yeah, where's your completion?
Where's your completion? Your mom and dad, they were like, you didn't even beat Dark Souls.
No, whenever
pussy.
Whenever I go on, like, Xbox Live or whatever, or, like, PS4, and I, like, browse other people's cards or whatever,
yeah,
and then it's like, I have a zillion billion points, and I've, like, have all the trophies on everything. I'm just like, wow.
You know, it's funny. My, like, PlayStation and Xbox score are really low, because, like, I don't complete every single game. I only complete the games I want to play.
Yeah.
So, like, if you look at my gamer score, I have a pretty low score, but, like, all the games I have are, like, fully done.
Oh my god.
And so people look at my trophy list and they're like, oh, what a casual! And they just, like, sit there and make fun of me.
When Aaron was on the tester, didn't you, they give you a hard time because you didn't have any points on your fucking, like,
oh, they, like,
PS4
they did that awkward,
some shit PS3 account? Right.
They did that awkward thing of, like,
and you're just like,
he doesn't have any trophies.
Okay. Do you remember that, Aaron?
Yeah, well, what's funny is that wasn't even my account.
Oh, it wasn't?
No.
Whose account was
it? Like a Sony given account?
Someone just had the name Egoraptor?
Yeah, because my account was like, Rob Pierogi or something.
Yeah.
Like Egoraptor backwards. So, they were just like, your account has like 7 trophies. And I was like, okay. Which, it seemed pretty accurate. I'm sure my account was comparable, but the fact that they looked up not my account is hilarious.
That's so, that shows some fucking dumb.
Yeah, that was good stuff.
It wasn't even your account.
Yeah, it wasn't even his account, and he got blamed for it.
I just love how they edited it, because they were like, tell us about your YouTube channel. Like, you have a lot of subscribers, don't you? Blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, yeah, I have a lot of subscribers. And then, like, in the show, they edit it for, it's like, they're like, so, here you are talking to us, and I'm like, I have a million subscribers!
Yeah, they edited it, so Aaron was like, and then when, I remember some guy asked you at one of the panels, he's like, so, I mean, it's no secret that you're kind of an asshole on the test, and he's like, dude!
Yeah.
Reality TV, they edit everyone to be an asshole, you know? Like, yeah. It's so funny.
I mean, I was being
stupid.
An asshole to the show on the first episode.
Yeah, but they turned it back on you.
Yeah, they were just like, fuck this guy, and took me off. It was not fair. As far as I can tell, the episode I got, I'm not bitter about it, like, because I don't give two shits. But, like, I'm pretty sure the last episode was rigged.
Oh,
absolutely!
Absolutely! The
absolutely,
melons,
dude!
Oh, yeah. You didn't even teach them how to use the melons!
Well, not only that, but, like, I'm pretty sure the other team, like, took a little bit longer.
Yeah, they totally had- No, there was a way to tell. Like, there was more melons on the firing field than your team had.
Well, it just felt like it. Like, when we were waiting for them, we were like, man, they're taking a really long time. And, like, they had some, they had some problem where they had to, like, restart or something, or like, something like that. Something that costed them a lot of time, and we could hear it, but they didn't put it in the episode.
Of course they didn't. It's fucking reality TV, man.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they, like,
I watched Holly do fucking Heroes of Cosplay, and that's like, like,
it's hilarious that they chose that episode to kick me off on, because, like, that was the one where I was, like, absolutely the most helpful.
Yeah.
Yeah, you were, like, super passionate about helping everyone.
Yeah, I hit the first target immediately, and then, like, ran as fast as I could to, like, reload all the melons. So, I don't know, it's pretty funny.
Yeah, whatever. Reality TV's dumb. That's why I'm glad that we have complete control over GameGrumps.
That
came out good.
So, this is I don't know if Jared told you guys this story, but Jared and I almost both got on that show, King of the Nerds.
I knew that, actually, because he's like, I'm in town.
Yeah, they invited both Jared and I for, like, the auditions. Well, first they hit me up because Jay Witz recommended me.
Yeah.
And then I had my interview, and the woman was like, you're perfect, we need guys like you. And I'm like, okay, cool, let me know. And so they, like, made me go through this really extensive casting process.
Right.
And they were like, do you have any friends? And I'm like, oh, yeah, I got Jared. He's really good. And so I introduced him to Jared's channel. They loved Jared.
You were
going like,
to on camera. Good
that was Yeah, that was the plan. That was the plan. One team,
two
one dream kind of thing.
Come one.
And so they went ahead and like, were like, okay, we're going to have you come out for the final calls and all this stuff.
Oh, fuck.
It sucks, they still sap your rings.
Hey, notice how they had to use the other sprite because they didn't have a turning sprite for Supersonic?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, they, the week before the final casting thing happens, the woman just goes, hey, we don't, like, need you. We're like, we're not gonna end up using you for the casting call.
Right, right.
And I was like, wait, so... And then Jared, like, immediately afterward calls me and goes, hey, man, I'm gonna be in LA for the thing, I'll see you there? And I'm like, no, you're not gonna see me there, because they passed on me. He was like, what? I'm like, yeah, you're gonna be on the show, dude. And he's like, but I wanted to be on the show because you were on the show. And I'm like, I'm sorry, man, it's just how it is. And then they flew Jared out. He was doing Con Bravo, and they flew him out to not go to Con Bravo. And then he shows up. And they were like, they did the casting call for a few days, and then they sent him home, and he didn't get casted in the show.
I remember, yeah, because he was like, hey, man, I'm in LA, and I'm like, can we see you? He was like, no, I'm in a hotel room, they won't let me leave, and then he's like, I'm going home.
That was the same with the tester.
Yeah.
They wouldn't let me, like, have a book in my room. I was literally, like, just in a room for, like, an entire day. A hotel room.
They wouldn't let you have a book?
Me. Yeah. They didn't want me to have anything. It was fucking weird.
Because they want you to be stressed out, I guess? I don't know.
They just don't want me to have any, like, contact with the outside world. They want me to be pure.
It's a book.
I know. So I watched, like, some shitty TV and talked to, like, this really nice cast member who was, like, my contact.
Uh-huh.
I was just, like, bored, so I just, like, called her and was like, hey, so, what's up? And she was super nice.
No!
It, like, passed a couple hours.
Lame.
That's funny. Yeah, reality TV's dumb. I hate reality TV.
I actually, like, oh, man, I forgot about this.
Yeah, what?
It was, they did, like, pre-casting,
yeah.
And it was over Skype.
Right.
And, I was, like, communicating with a lot of the other people that were, like, on top of the voting.
Oh.
And a lot of the people got interviewed, and, like, I guess there was, like, this girl that was, like, sort of, like, she was like, yeah, like, the guy was really, like, harassy, like, not cool.
Whoa,
and
weird.
I was like, oh, man, that sucks. And then I talked to another girl that was also, and she was like, yeah, I got the same thing. And I was like, whoa, geez. So, like, I, like, called up my contact and was like, hey, like, this guy, like, totally fucking harassed these girls. Like, I don't know if you want to do anything about this. And they were like, oh, okay, thank you for the information. I don't know if anything ever came of that, but...
Is that it?
That's pretty much it.
So, can I tell you, before we finish this episode, can I tell a reality TV story that I had?
Yeah, sure.
So, my wife, Holly Conrad, was on Heroes of Cosplay, right? Which was the sci-fi cosplay show. And... via association, I guess, in her contract was that if you were married, your spouse had to be on the show, and that was negotiated, and I found out about it the day of, so I was kind of like...
Miffed?
Yeah, so, I was a little niffed, because I didn't want to be on it. And, anyway, what happened was, they were like, I had nothing to do with any of the competitions, and they kept trying to bring me into the, like, the conversation. So when they were filming at our house, they'd be like, all right, Ross, could you just come in here and just, like, sit down and, like, join them? They're gonna sit in the living room and, like, talk about the other contestants. So I was like, all right. So I sat down, and I was wearing my, I think, like, either Game Grumps or it was, like a Maker hoodie I was given or some shit like that. Some gray, generic hoodie. And I just wore it. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna fucking Daniel Radcliffe this shit. So every time they ask me to come out and do that same shit again, like, they'll be like, oh, Russ, could you talk about the contestants? I'm like, I don't know any of them! Like, I don't know who these people are! Like, so I'm fucking sitting there. And then anyway, later we get these notes back from Sci-Fi. I kept doing this. And we got these notes back from Sci-Fi saying, hey, do we have any more footage of Russ? Because every time they ask for me, I put on the same jacket. So if you watch Heroes of Cosplay, I am literally in the same jacket every time playing Monster Hunter, ignoring everything.
Yeah.
Because I did not give two flying fucks.
Yeah, man. I mean, yeah. it's so easy when you know how those shows are made, it's so easy to, like, at least, like, get some headway in how you present yourself.
Secret!
Yay!
But dude, the other thing, sorry, keep going. I won't interrupt.
Well, when I was on Dance Showdown, like, and I first met Maxine, like, they wanted to make a thing out of it, and they were like, so, what'd you think of Maxine? And I was like, oh, she was really cool and really nice, and, like,
they were like,
really
that's nice it?
Yeah, and they're like, what else do you think? And I was like, I think she was really nice and cool, and it was really nice to meet her. And they were like, come on, you didn't, like, you know, like, she's, like, really pretty, right? And I was like, yeah. It's just like, they can't use that. Yeah. And then they're like, come on, man, like, didn't you think she was hot? And I'm like, yeah, but I'm not gonna say that. And then,
also,
like,
I have,
like,
I also,
right,
I have a wife.
Yes. So, that's fucking hilarious. Because they'll totally frankenbite you if you say anything
absolutely.
Like that.
So, like, if you watch that scene, it's just like, when I met Maxine, she was really nice and cool. Like, that's... It's like, yeah, that's totally what I wanted to communicate.
I love how we all have reality TV stories.
I'm not gonna fucking let them use me to objectify women in a fucking reality
show. Can I just say that, like, I always found it interesting whenever, like, Heroes of Cosplay was playing in, like, Sweden or something, a few of our fans would tweet, like, oh my god, I saw you on Heroes of Cosplay, that's crazy, you're on TV! I'm like, you know, I'm just gonna be honest, like, GameGrumps gets more views than Heroes of Cosplay. It's really not that big a deal. Like, legit, like, internet stuff is now getting more views than most television shows.
Yeah, dude, I'll bring it all back to fucking, I want to meet PewDiePie.
Yeah, right? Yeah, exactly.
I mean, I want to meet PewDiePie.
I met him once. He's Swedish.
I've met him a million times.
I've actually met him a few times, yeah. He's a really nice guy.
We're friends on Twitter,
but he's a really good dude.
I've never met him in person.
Well, next time on Grumpcade, PewDiePie.
Really? Yeah, we just come back and like fucking Gerard's so gone and like PewDiePie's completing.
Felix just replaces me for the series.
Next time.
I'm really having a great time.